Well, let's just move on and have some more fun and games today. Didn't y'all have fun at that last class?
Mm-hmm. I had a lot of fun.
And so let's have some more fun. So we're still talking about chapter one because I'm giving everybody a chance to get their footing on this chapter one. And in our last class, I want to advise all of you, if you want to participate in the Socrative, I may have some questions that you may want to answer, so I wanted to give you that heads up so that you could get into that if you want to do it. But we're still on chapter one, and I want to get right into what we're going to talk about today because we're going to have a little bit of length in there, so I want to get it all in. And so this is straight from your textbook because I read that textbook. So I'm hoping that you all are reading that. And these are our learning objectives for chapter one. We, in our last class, we talked about some sources of law. We talked about sources of law. And we talked about, I'm gonna go back to our key point, because our key point is that we need to know the laws because we need to not get into business and lose money on lawsuits. That's really the key point. And we talked about some sources of law, constitutional law, statutory law, administrative law, and we talked about my favorite, which is common law. And then I left this little figure in here because I had some interesting questions in our last class about state law, federal law. And so now we're going to talk about some categories of law. Let me go back to our learning objectives. We're going to move into categories of law. And then we talk about public laws and private laws. Public laws are derived from some government entity, like the Department of Labor. And then you have your private laws. Like let's say I walk into your store and I slip down because your floor is wet. Then I'm gonna sue you. It may not be based on any law that is derived from any governmental entity or any statute or anything like that, but it's gonna be law that is derived from common law that we talked about earlier. And so you will remember that in our last class, would you agree that that was more public law, Mr. Orbez? Yes. It was more public law because it came straight from this statute, from this administrative law governmental agency. So that was a better definition of public law. So today, let's see if we can talk about some private laws.
One of the greatest wrestlers of all time just got sucker punched.
When you see the words Hulk Hogan sex tape, you have that moment before you decide whether or not to click it.
Hogan's $100 million lawsuit over a tape that was posted online by the website Gawker. The first celebrity sex tape case to go to trial.
Put internet privacy in a battle against freedom of the press.
Gawker becomes convinced that somebody else with a different agenda is financing this lawsuit.
Billionaire Peter Thiel and co-founder of PayPal is secretly paying the expenses of Hulk Hogan's legal fight.
The story about his sexual orientation was published 9 years before this lawsuit.
This is personal.
He's doing this because he wants to bring Gawker down.
We're going to open up those libel laws, and we're going to have people sue you like you never got sued before.
Donald Trump, Peter Thiel, and other billionaires
have been trying to undercut freedom of speech.
Sheldon Adelson bought the Las Vegas Review-Journal. What he did was take off the boards people who might reveal something that he doesn't like.
Billionaires are proclaiming we are more powerful than the truth.
This is a moment of real definition for the press.
You are treating the news.
Journalism is worth protecting. If we lose that, we've lost what America stands for. We have to fight harder and smarter than ever.
Here's a message to the White House. You keep lying, we're going to keep reporting.
The president believes the press is a threat to the country.
The facts are not facts. It's not as
easy as I do. But he can't silence me.
We're talking about truth.
He's going to turn the lights on.
Okay. So if y'all want to watch that version of the facts, get it on Netflix. Here is something a little closer.
Get the edge with Pro Football Focus. Be prepared for every round of your fantasy draft. Make David.
Hulk Hogan, former professional wrestler turned reality star, is taking down media website Gawker. The issue, Gawker published part of a Hulk Hogan sex tape, and the costly courtroom battle is bringing Gawker to its knees. Here's a breakdown of the fight, punch by punch. News reports begin to circulate on the internet about a possible Hulk Hogan sex tape. Gawker posts a 1 minute 40 second montage from a sex tape recorded in 2006 featuring Hogan and Heather Klemm, the wife of Hogan's friend and radio host, Bubba the Love Sponge Klemm. Former Gawker editor AJ DeLorio also posts more than 1,400 words about the full 30 minute tape. Hogan files two lawsuits, the first against Bubba and Heather Klemm, the second against Gawker for $100 million, alleging defamation and invasion of privacy. Hogan says he never knew he was being taped. Gawker says showing the footage is protected under the Constitution because Hogan has made his sex life a matter of public interest. Hogan and Bubba reach a settlement, and Bubba issues a statement saying, quote, Hulk Hogan was unaware of the presence of the recording device in my bedroom. A district court judge sides with Gawker, saying, quote, the balance between the First Amendment and copyright is preserved in part.
And so I'm just going to try to see if I can go through some of the facts based on what CNN said. It's just really close to what went on. But back in 2006, I'm going to call him Hulk Hogan, was having an interlude with Ms. Clint while being videotaped. In that trial, he claimed that the videotaping was without his knowledge or consent. However, he's on the Howard Stern show, and he tells Howard Stern that he did this because he was feeling depressed. And so He was going through a divorce with his wife, and you know, he was not himself, and he just agreed to do this based on the fact that he was feeling depressed, and he thought that these people were his friends. Yes.
He agreed to videotape it or
no,
his wife?
Well, no, he agreed to, he is saying that many advances had been made towards him by Ms. Klemm, and okay, that Ms. Klemm and Bubba carried on an alternative lifestyle.
Okay.
And so he had been propositioned on numerous occasions to carry on activities.
Okay. But it still doesn't state that he knew he was being videotaped.
No.
Okay.
He is, that's what the whole lawsuit is about.
He's clear.
He's clear that he did not know, he did not give his consent. Mm-hmm. And when it all came out, I mean, nobody had his consent to publish it. Okay, so Bubba testified that he taped it and kept it in a drawer. Obviously, that was their intent, was to tape it and leak the sex tape. The problem here, I'm assuming, is that these days people like to leak their own sex tapes. And so somebody beat it to the punch anyway. So, and so here we are, $100 million later.
140.
Yeah. Well, a little less than that, as in all said and done. So he originally sued Gawker for copyright infringement in United States District Court. Okay. So, and then in the District of Florida, and he sought a temporary injunction, but the judge there was not buying it at all. In his estimation, he could not see how it could be copyright infringement because, and he really did use the wrong cause of action in that particular respect because it was not his tape. So it was Bubba's tape. So Bubba could sue for copyright infringement. But he couldn't. I mean, it probably would have been, you know, completely all rights reserved because he didn't give him permission. But I can see where the district judge, the federal court judge, was not really buying the fact that it was copyright infringement. And so he says, okay, federal court, I'm done with you. And he goes to state court and he refiles that same lawsuit in Florida State Court, where he finds Miss Judge Pamela Campbell, who is all for him. And she buys all of everything that he's selling. And so she ordered Gawker to remove the video and because Gawker, they did a little write-up and they did a whole, you know, they did a whole thing. And they put it on their website. She said she granted an injunction and asked them to take it down. Well, Gawker appealed that, and the Court of Appeals said, well, they have a First Amendment right as the media. And so the Court of Appeals sided with Gawker, and with that restraint on their First Amendment right, Gawker was sure that the state court judge, Judge Pamela, would dismiss the suit, but she did not. And so the case went on to trial. We'll come back to some of these facts, but the case went on to trial. The trial lasted 2 weeks. And in the end, Hulk Hogan was awarded $115 million. There was some racy testimony in that trial that we will not be partaking in here. But Hulk Hogan's argument was that, one of their arguments, Gawker's argument, was that, okay, Hulk Hogan, you go out here, you go on the Howard Stern show, you go on everybody's show, Bubba and everybody else, and you talk about all of your activities. So how can you say that your right to privacy was invaded? You go out there and you put it all out there yourself. During the trial, Hulk Hogan says, no, when I go out and I'm talking in those terms, I'm talking about Hulk Hogan, not Mr. Bolet. I'm talking about Hulk Hogan, which is another person. So their argument is that you're even talking about all kinds of things, including the size of parts of your body. But he's saying, no, I'm saying that part of the body, the size of that part of the body I'm talking about is Hulk Hogan's. So these are, I'm just telling you, because we're not going to show it, because he's on trial saying, no, that's Hulk Hogan's. I was telling Howard Stern about Hulk Hogan's package. And so, okay, so let's take, you know, so here, and you know, okay, so let me just go on with this. And so Gawker filed a motion after the award from the jury. Gawker filed a motion, what we call, to stay execution of the judgment, which means to just let it sit while I appeal. That means if the judge stays execution of this judgment on appeal, that means I don't have to pay it. right now. And their argument was that they couldn't afford to pay $140 million judgment. And when you go on appeal, the law says mostly that if I'm going to stay execution of the judgment, you're going to have to post a bond for me to do that. They didn't have the $50 million to post the appeal bond either, they claim. Okay. And so they, Gawker files bankruptcy. In the meantime, Univision buys Gawker in a bankruptcy sale. And they shut down the site. And then later on, when you, I could tell you this case is going to settle somewhere under here, under this $50 million, because it has to settle. I mean, it's, you know. And so on November the 2nd, Gawker settles the case with Hulk Hogan for $31 million. All right, so here is the state court lawsuit that Hulk Hogan files after the district court tells him, no, thank you. And this is what it looks like. This is the state court, the Florida state court lawsuit. And, you know, he goes through the facts and he calls it, I like the way he called it, a highlight reel. He said, Gawker posted to the internet a 1-minute and 40-second highlight reel. That's what he called it. And so, I'm looking for somebody in here who is going to be the owner of Gawker. And I am looking for a volunteer. Thank you, Ms. Gawker. With your bankrupt self. Okay, so, Ms. Gawker. Hulk Hogan is saying you're using his fame to post this highlight reel so that you can, because the way that you get business for your company is through advertisements on your website. Is that how you do it? Which to me, I cannot believe it that you make this kind of money doing this, but you do. You make millions. I did highlight this word because, you know, I filed many lawsuits in my day. I've never used the word loathsome. I mean, they were really just completely done with Gawker. These loathsome defendants. I love that language. And so, so this is their lawsuit. And so he talks about their malicious conduct violates his constitutional and common law privacy rights. So we have another public/private law case coming up here. And it talks about all the parties. And then he goes through all of the facts where he, you know, he clearly says he did not know that the activities were being videotaped. And I really don't think he knew. He was really hurt about it. I mean, he acted like he was really hurt. Gawker. And then, but however, Gawker says, this tape just arrived mysteriously in their mailbox. It just, poof, a sex tape. Really? They're saying, hey, I mean, well, why are you suing us? We had nothing to do with how this tape came to be. Yes, sir.
Wouldn't they be better off, like, filing criminal charges first, like, they receive the stolen goods?
Criminal?
If they filed that first, then they get guilty of that, then they'd have, like, a case saying, hey, they obviously have something going on.
Let me ask you, how many dollars can you get from a criminal case?
That's not the point. The point is that if they look guilty, then you go to the civil case. The civil case bring the dollars.
No, you don't have to waste time with that because you won't get the money from the civil case anyway.
I'm saying, but you,
I mean, there's no need for that because we have criminal law. We have, I mean,
yeah, OJ.
Criminal law is different. I want some money. I ain't got time to waste my time. I already got to get, I got to get Mr. Teal to come and finance because you have to pay lawyers to do these things for you. Yeah. So I just want to jump right in and get my money. That's why we bring civil law. And so the civil law has given him causes of action to do that. They're saying, hey, we just got this tape. It just dropped into my lap.
Strangely.
You know nothing about it. Just strangely appeared in your mailbox.
It must be true. I mean, if it was illegal, why weren't they arrested for it? So obviously they're telling the truth, right?
No, because it's not illegal to get a sex tape.
If it's stolen, it is. It's received as stolen goods.
No, listen. Why you bringing it? See, I need y'all to be able to stay with the facts. Who said it was stolen?
Nobody was. That's what I'm saying. Like, it's totally legit.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
That's what I'm saying.
Nothing was stolen.
Exactly.
Okay. It just, somebody just gave it to somebody.
Yeah.
It was a gift.
It just happened.
Uh-huh.
Right.
Yeah.
So there's no crime here.
Right.
Okay. I'm just letting you know.
I'm just saying you can't argue that there was what I was trying to say, which was, yeah, we're saying the same thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No. But how did we even get to crimes?
I felt like you were insinuating that that was on the up and up. They just, you know,
no, it's not on, I don't believe it.
Okay.
But I'm not saying it's a crime.
Oh.
I don't believe that Ms. Gawker just went to her mailbox. Oh, let me go check my mailbox. She opened up her mailbox and, oh, here's a sex tape. No, I don't think so. But I don't know how all this came to be. Okay, so the footage was not blocked, blurred, or obscured. That's what he's saying. He's saying, you know, come on, you gonna put me all out there? You just put it all out there. And then he says that they put English subtitles to the video to ensure that that viewers did not miss a word of their private account.
English subtitles.
and so then on October the 4th, Gawker defendants published on their site the video depicting claims of private consensual sexual relations with an anonymous woman. See, up at some point, up until some point, nobody knew who she. Everybody claimed they didn't know who she was, including Hulk Hogan. I don't know who that woman is. So, and so, so he said that they edited the video without his knowledge or his consent. He made repeated requests for them to take it down, Ms. Gawker. After I come to you and say, okay, you've had your fun, can you take it down? You still not calling.
they did
not take it down. And he says, at no time prior to, during, or after the private consensual sexual encounter between Ms. Hulk Hogan and Ms. Clem did Hulk Hogan ever authorize the consent. The video and the narrative have never been authorized by him. And so he goes through all of his facts. He talks about how much he has suffered and continues to suffer because somebody else leaked his sex tape. So here are our mix of private / public laws. Publication of private facts, that's going to be a private law. And he alleges that against many of the different defendants. Invasion of privacy. Okay. From the Constitution, we all have a right to privacy. Okay. And even there are some state laws that supplant your right to privacy. So this is going to go more on the public law side. And then violation of Florida common law right to privacy. That's going to go more on the private law side because this is derived from common law, not necessarily from any governmental entity, any constitution, statute, anything like that. Okay? And negligent infliction of emotional distress, everybody throws that in. And here, violation of section 934. This might be described as some type of a public law. So we have our mix of public slash private laws. Okay, so then at some point, Gawker files a motion for summary judgment because surely the Court of Appeals has said that they had a constitutional right, freedom of the press, to publish that video. Yes, ma'am.
Remember last class when we were talking about like it all goes on based on how the law is interpreted?
Mm-hmm.
Wasn't one of the it could have been amended, I just might know, but when I was taught in school that the first the Bill of Rights and all that, the rights of the press was ordered to talk about what's going on in the government, not necessarily say what you want. Like, for example, like free speech.
Mm-hmm.
This is the right to speak up against the government. So what is that?
So, freedom of the press.
Right, well.
Freedom of the press.
Wasn't it also,
I'm
written to publicize what the government's doing and.
Yeah, freedom of the press to publish anything that's of a public concern.
So this would be considered public concern?
That's what the judge said.
I just wanted, okay.
That, and so since the judge said that they had the freedom to publish that because it was a public concern, they said, okay, Miss Judge Pamela, let's just file a motion for summary judgment in your court because as a matter of law, the judge has said we have a right to publish it. Yes, ma'am. I mean, yes, sir. I'm sorry.
Even if the judge was right saying that
okay.
They have a right to posting that video.
Wait. Even if the judge was right in saying what?
Yeah, like wouldn't Logan be entitled to some of the money like earned from the video, even if
because
they're using his likeness without his consent?
It could be that at some point that somebody could have
that
said
route.
That,
yeah.
But he sued for copyright infringement and laws.
It really was not his video, and you just have to be careful. In life. Yes, ma'am.
So, a motion for summary judgment, does that mean that you're saying you want to hurry up and get it done with, like, make a decision right now?
If you determine that as a matter of law, that there's no need for us to have a trial and bring in a jury, because as a matter of law, I mean, why are we wasting, well, let's not waste our time. The law has said, and the judge has said, that I have a freedom of the press right to publish this because this is a public concern. Why are we going to waste our time? And have a trial.
So it's like foregoing trial.
This is going to forego the trial. Every good lawyer is going to try this. And so they go through and they go through all of their little legal arguments and everything. And they cite the common law that entitles them to judgment as a matter of law. And then I'm not going to bore you with the facts because we've already gone through all of this. But then at some point, they start to do their analysis when they say that because the publication was published against a backdrop of a substantial public discussion of Hogan's activities, including by Mr. Hogan on the Howard Stern Show and everywhere else, it involves a matter of public concern and is therefore absolutely protected by the First Amendment. Yes, ma'am.
But Hulk Hogan didn't sue him. Terry Bellino sued him.
Yes. To them, they're one and the same.
But they're not. Hogan is a persona.
That's what Hogan is saying. They're
but
not
anybody saying that. I mean, you can't base a character.
They're saying he's one and the same.
So
Gawker is saying it's absurd for you to go around saying that when you talk about the body part sizes of yourself, you're saying the ones you're talking about are the ones of Hulk Hogan and not yourself. Hulk Hogan's is gigantuan. Mine is little. They're saying that's absurd. You're the same person. They're not going, that's not, these are Gawker's facts here. Gawker's not, that's not their argument. That's Hulk Hogan. Hulk Hogan is saying, I don't know what you're talking about. You're saying that I'm going around talking about this myself. No, I was talking about Hulk Hogan. I wasn't talking about Balea.
Well, then maybe Hulk Hogan gave permission to put that video on there.
But that's saying that I can walk up to Kate Blanchett and ask her to be God for me because she was in the movie.
God.
You know,
well, no, but if I publish a sex tape and I put it under Hulk Hogan,
my God, I have a favor.
You know. Well, listen, I'm not getting that. That's Hulk Hogan is trying to get out of the fact that he's going around on Howard Stern, la-di-da-di everybody, and talking about his activities. So when he gets in court and they say, hey, what do you mean it's a right to privacy? He said, oh, I was talking about Hulk Hogan, not the person that sued you. Yes, sir.
So just a quick, like, relation to this. If someone had, if say, like, there's a guy in the men's bathroom and he was taking pictures of other guys, would
okay.
that kind of be along the same lines of what this is or not?
What kind of that's?
Because it's a right to privacy. And it's like without
well, no,
consent.
No, because Gawker didn't do it, though. Gawker didn't make the tape. He
oh,
just
right.
got the tape.
Okay,
received
so.
It.
Yeah.
Just received the tape.
Yeah.
But acting complacent like
in
that.
In some
is that
instance,
kind of,
that now that's ill. That's border. That's illegal.
That's
yeah.
I mean, that's
wouldn't
a crime.
It's a criminal charge.
Wouldn't there be like a level of privacy in a bedroom?
There's a level of privacy in a bedroom for a normal person,
right.
But if you're going around with a reality TV show, you putting people in a sleeper hole. On national TV, and you go on a Howard Stern show and you talk about all your business.
Yeah.
That's, I don't know. That's all I'm saying. And so here they go straight to the common law. They say a claim for invasion of privacy / publication of private facts requires that the speech. An issue not involve a matter of public concern. Claims for intrusion upon seclusion and intentional infliction of emotional distress. Oh, I'm just distressed that my sex tape got me. Cannot be based on speech involving a matter of public concern. And here is they're going to get their precedent. Put it right in there. Because when I go to the judge and I say, Judge, based on the First Amendment, freedom of the press, I have the right to talk about this and publish this information. And the reason I do it is because I'm telling you I do, Judge. No. You're going to have to bring a case that interprets that First Amendment to the court. To prove up your allegation. And so they say, as the court is aware in prior proceedings, they say they go straight, this is really where they go. In prior proceedings, both the United States District Court, the district judge, the federal court that said, huh, no, this is not copyright infringement. And a unanimous panel of the District Court of Appeals conclude that the publication involved a matter of public concern. And then they talked about what the federal court judge talked about. And then they say application refiled in state court, the Court of Appeals repeatedly held that it is clear that the report and the related video excerpts address matters of public concern. So you would think that they should win this, that the that Judge Pamela should grant their motion for summary judgment, right? Well, she does not grant the motion for summary judgment. I'm going to take you straight to, this is, so what they do is they, this, I'm just showing you this case right here is the Court of Appeals opinion. And this is the pinpoint, what we call a pinpoint citation. Every case has a fingerprint like this. They have, this number is unique to this case, and then this is the page where you're going to find that. And so I'm going to go, if I'm a good attorney, I'm going to go and I'm going to see if I'm going to see exactly if that is exactly what was said on that page. Here, on page 1201, in that opinion. They talk all about Hulk Hogan. They really do lay the foundation. They say, where motions, where matters of purely private significance are at issue, the First Amendment protections are often less rigorous. Meaning, if it's purely private, Gawker can't go put like just for me, I'm just like nobody, you know. It's a private matter. I have a right to privacy. Gawker can't just go put that out there on their website. That would be an invasion of my privacy. I'm not Hulk Hogan. This says, on the other hand, speech on matters of public concern is at the heart of the First Amendment's protections. They go on to say, speech deals with matters of public concern when it can be fairly considered as relating to any matter of political, social, another concern to the community, or when it's the subject of legitimate news interest that is a subject of general interest and a value of concern to the public. And then they say, Hulk Hogan, better known as Hulk Hogan, enjoyed the spotlight as a professional wrestler, and he and his family were depicted in a reality television show detailing their personal lives. Mr. Boyle openly discussed an affair he had while married to his wife in his published autobiography.
Hey,
Hulk Hogan's or
his?
It says his. But listen, I know you want to separate these people, but they're the same.
Between Hannah Montana and the acting from Miley.
Yes.
There
was no thought behind. Yes.
But technically, isn't it two different people just like.
But doesn't Hulk Hogan.
Because
he exists.
He exists, but yeah, exactly. So he's like a persona, like he's its own character.
He may be a persona, but he is a famous persona, and his right to privacy is diminished for that reason. Yes, ma'am.
But then if he's just saying like Hulk Hogan is separate from who I am, and Gawker posts the article saying Hulk Hogan sex tape, then he kind of makes his point moot anyway, because I'm not talking about you, Terry, Jean, Boella, whatever. I'm talking about Hulk Hogan sex tape. So technically, I still have freedom of speech because you're technically still. I'm only making this article about a public figure, and not a private one.
Right. That's the whole point. Cause who cares about my sex tape? Nobody. Yes, sir.
So basically what I'm getting from this is if you're a famous person, basically your whole life is of public interest, and that kind of like gives a little bit more leeway for things done against you or without your knowledge. Is that what the law's kind of...
Not just that, but the fact that you yourself go out there and put your business out in the street. So they say, despite Mr. Bola's public persona, we do not suggest that every aspect of his private life is a subject of public concern. However, the mere fact that the publication contains private matters, explicit content, does not remove it from the realm of legitimate public interest. That alone is not going to do it. It says, it is clear that as a result of the public controversy surrounding the affair and sex tape, exacerbated in part by Hulk Hogan himself, the report and the related video excerpts address are matters. Here on page 1201, the court does hold that these are matters of public concern. The Court of Appeals, this is the Florida Court of Appeals. This is a court that is higher than Ms. Pamela. Ms. Pamela, so Gawker says, oh, great. Let me go back to Ms. Pamela and file my little motion for summary judgment, because the judge who reviews her decisions has said this is a matter of public concern. She says that motion is denied, and this matter is going to a trial by jury.
$48.7 million in gross revenue. That's how much money came in the door before any expenses, before it paid its employees, before it paid its rent, before it paid for anything. That's how much money it took in. Now, after paying all of those expenses, it must pay an award of $115 million.
All right, now. Talked about posting the bond. That's not what I want. Let me go back here. Okay, so he says the company is worth how much?
$83 million.
Uh-huh. How much did Univision buy it for?
$135 million.
Something's not right. Yes, sir.
I was curious, after they filed bankruptcy, did Hulk Hogan get his full $140 million?
No, he settled.
He settled it for $31
million.
No. They filed bankruptcy, okay? In a bankruptcy auction, Univision buys the company for $135 million.
Oh, that's why, because it was auctioned.
It's a bankruptcy. That money goes to the bankruptcy trustee, and he pays off the creditors.
Yeah.
So that, and I'm not so certain how much Hulk Hogan would have gotten from the bankruptcy trustee if he had asserted his claim to the bankruptcy trustee. In the meantime, In the meantime, the judge upholds the judgment. So unless the bankruptcy court at some point says that that particular debt is discharged in the bankruptcy, which I doubt it was, he would still owe that judgment. And so to just wipe this clean, they just go ahead and settle the case post-judgment for $31 million. Okay? Okay, so I'm going to give you time to get in there. Now, let's not have any wise guy answers to this question. Okay, I know it wasn't you. Which legal argument do you favor? A, the jury's verdict in favor of Hulk Hogan's claims, including his invasion of privacy claims, or Gawker's claim that it had a First Amendment right to publish because the materials related to matters of public concern. So, let's see if anybody is in favor of this. Kill. Here are a few people who are going to help you out.
There are just a few people who answered. 19 out of 22.
Okay. So, are there any questions about this? We're finished with chapter one now, and so make sure that you turn in your assignments. Are there any questions about this? Yes, sir.
So, I'm going to ask, what was the judge, Pamela's, reasoning to overrule the court appeal?
One thing about Judge Pamela is she never really wrote anything. She just gave rulings. She would just say denied. No written explanation. So we don't know. Are there any other questions? Yes, ma'am.
Well, wait, so it was by trial though, right? So the jury decided
ultimately. Right? So before the trial, when she denied the motion for summary judgment, she didn't give a reason.
Okay.